precursors, especially in the axis or branch over which flowers are produced in a definite manner. Inflorescence has two parts, that is the peduncle and flower. That means this is the peduncle and on both sides there is the presence of flowers. Example in Sesamilia, in Jasmine, many flowers are arranged on a single peduncle. All the flowers do not mature at the same time. Older flower present at the base, younger flower present at the apex. These all flowers are not mature at a time. Some flowers mature first and some flowers mature after some time. Importance. What is the importance of bunch of flower or group of flowers or inflorescence? First importance, more attractive than single or solitary flower. Second, chances of pollination increased by pollinators. That is more chances of pollination. Why? When any type of pollinating agent, that is the birds, insects, honeybees coming towards the inflorescence, what happens? Many pollen grains are attached to their body and pollination chances increased. Then more yield. Due to increase the pollination, flower produces, each and every flower produces grain or fruit and therefore yield get increased to upanna vada. And more significant. Inflorescence is more significant than a single flower because production of crop yield. Pikaansu upanna vada. This is all about inflorescence. Then next time you will see the study of types of inflorescence. That is the racemose inflorescence and cymose inflorescence. There are two types of inflorescence. Okay.